Hi.
Is it good? We good?
I think so. Yes, I think so.
Okay, well, welcome to Main Line tonight, Jeannie Wolfington. My name is Melissa Jacobs. We are talking about the 48th Annual Academy of Notre Dame Dana Moore Fine Art Show and Sale. And Jeannie, you are the signature artist this year. What an honor. Of course, we have some of your amazing artwork behind you. Can you show us a few pieces?
Yes, absolutely. I have a pink tulip painting, 38 by 38. So a lot of pink tulip paintings this year. I think it's just, you know, a happy, bright, cheerful, you know, positive painting. So, and some other...
Can you actually pick up? You know what? Why don't you leave the... Oh, what? Okay.
I know. I'm
nervous. Now I'm nervous.
I know. So I have even like smaller pieces, like this here is just like a block painting, 10 by 10, just a simple abstract, and, you know, 8 by 8 and seascapes.
Beautiful.
And some more floral.
Wow.
So lots of fun things. So.
Wow, gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Okay, so let's talk about it. So for everybody who's just joining us, my name is Melissa Jacobs. This is Main Line tonight. You're talking with Jeannie Wolfington. She is the signature artist for the 48th Annual Academy of Notre Dame Dana Moore Fine Art Show and Sale in Villanova, and virtually it starts January 30th. It runs through February 7th. You can follow Jeannie, or you can find out more at ndapa.org. So Jeannie, this is not the first year that you've been involved with the sale, right? You've done it before?
That's correct. This is my fourth year, so.
Yeah, but they made you the signature artist. So tell me how that works.
Yes, I'm so excited. So it was amazing. So I'm so thrilled to be the signature artist. So they really do such a great job, and there's so many parent volunteers that work so hard, and it's an amazing show. So it's really, it's a lot of local artists, and, you know, it really shows a lot of the local artists, like, skills, and it's amazing. So it's a shame that it's virtual this year, but like everything else, you know, it kind of, you know, it is.
Well, listen, COVID's not going to stop art.
Yeah, exactly.
So let's talk about your style a little bit. So you do florals and abstract florals, but let's talk about how you got into art, because you were not originally an artist, right? Tell us about your path into artistry.
I guess, honestly, I've always been an artist, but I guess, you know, when I went to college and high school, being an artist, it was kind of like, well, how are you going to make a living doing that? So I was a graphic designer.
I mean, that's a fair question, you know.
Yeah. That kind of was important, so, yeah.
Right.
So I was a graphic artist for over 20 years, so, which was great, because you can use your creativity, but it's, you know, it's very using computer software, and I just always loved painting, and I like to, you know, express myself through painting and colorful paintings, and, you know, it's hard to do that when you're in a corporate role, like as a graphic designer. So, but it was great. I mean, I enjoyed doing both, but I'm really happy I tried this out, and, you know. And
yeah, so this is like a second career for you, right?
Kind of, yeah.
Yeah,
I can say that.
And so you have like a really signature style, I think. With the colors and the way that you represent the flowers. So was that always your style, or did it take a while to develop that?
I just love color. Like, I've always, you know, been really into like interior decorating, and I love everything like color, design. You know, I just like to surround myself with like happy things and color and positive vibes, and so I think, you know, and I think sometimes, like, you know, you want to have something that brings your spirits up, so I thought, you know, I think art can do that. So.
Yes, definitely. Now let's talk about art during the pandemic, because it has changed your work a little bit. First of all, you're connecting with a ton of followers on social media just like this, right?
Yes, yes. Instagram has been amazing. It really has. It's almost like a real-time website that you can, you know, if you do a painting, you post it and, you know, you get comments, you know, either positive or negative, you know, and you can kind of gauge it out and see how people are. But it really, I mean, it's really like an amazing thing that you can do that. So it's great.
It is great. Yeah. So what are some of the, can you think of some comments? Because, you know, social media can also be a negative place with, you know, negative comments. But you're saying you've gotten positive comments from people that have been helpful?
Yeah, yeah, I think so. Yeah, I try to, I mean, I'm at the age now, I have three kids and, you know, I'm kind of like, it's kind of like you're doing what you want to do. And, you know, if you don't like it, that's fine. And, you know, that it is what it is. So it's all good.
That's a nice way to say it. I have other ways of saying it. If you don't like what I'm doing, okay, it's not for you. Right. Okay, so we want to say one more time, we're talking about the 48th Annual Academy of Notre Dame de Namur Fine Art Show and Sale. There's more information at ndapa.org. You can follow Jeannie, you can follow Randall Graham. They are, yes, so glad to have Jeannie and Randy on our show. Yes, it's great. It's great. And there are a lot of other artists, Alicia and a whole bunch of other artists. It's a great way that the school is supporting local artists. I'm really glad that they're doing the show virtually and not just canceling it. Yeah. So again, it's January 30th through February 7th. Jeannie, it's so good to have you on Main Live.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you soon. Take good care.
Thank you.
Have a great night, everybody. We'll see you again on Main Live tonight.
Okay.